Without further ado, we now have Melissa Jones with us, who we're really excited about. Please, Melissa, if you don't mind, introducing yourself quickly, kind of your role with your organization, and we'll take it from there.
Hi, thanks so much for having me, Mitch. Super excited to be here with you all today. As Mitch said, I'm Melissa Jones. I'm the Director of Development at Habitat for Humanity of Kansas City. We're a very large affiliate that serves six counties and supports over 4,500 volunteers here in Kansas City. I've been with the organization for over 4.5 years, have worked in fundraising and nonprofit world for about 12 years. I love everything nonprofit. I feel like people always are like, what is your passion? I'm like, not like my work is my passion, that they go hand in hand. So excited to share a little bit more about Giveffect and our journey on this platform that we have been navigating for the last few years.
Amazing. Well, we're glad to have you and hear a bit more about that journey that you've been on and how you tackled some of these challenges that you faced. That might be a helpful place to start. If you can think back a few years, and I know you mentioned just before having lots of different systems and disparate information. Can you just tell us a little bit about the state of play several years ago and some of the negative impacts that had on your ability to deliver on your programs?
Sure, absolutely. So prior to being on Giveffect, we were using six, honestly, I was thinking about this morning, it might have been seven different platforms. Anything from an email marketing, we had a CRM, event management, volunteer management, event ticketing, text message. So as you can imagine, different logins for each one. I'm telling you, not one platform talked to the other. So if you wanted to get data, you were downloading a spreadsheet and trying to lay it over another spreadsheet to figure out what this person was doing. In addition to it, it wasn't all electronic. So we had volunteers showing up to construction sites that never signed up online. They needed to fill out paper waivers. Hopefully that paper waiver then got to the data entry person who was putting it into the system. Probably it didn't happen all the time. So our state of our like data integrity was very, very low. It would be very common for someone to come to us and ask how many volunteer hours they had, and we would need to get a pen and paper out and start adding up days and hours. So we did not have a point of truth for everything or anything, honestly. We couldn't do drip campaigns. We couldn't, if I looked at one profile, I had no idea if you were a donor and a volunteer. So to say that we were in a slight mess is probably putting it nicely.
Well, thank you for the context. I'm sure at least part of that resonates with a lot of people in the audience today. So when you thought about making a change or doing something differently, how did you go about doing that? What was the process like for you?
Sure. So we really sat down with our resource development team and started laying out goals. What are the top things that we need to achieve when we make this migration? One of the things was a single point of truth for all data. We wanted to make sure that we were taking all of our logins and putting it under one place so that Mitch, if you were a supporter of ours, I could pull up your profile and say, oh, well, Mitch has been volunteering for 2 years. He's also donated $1,500. He's opened three emails and clicked this link, and he's got these text messages. We needed that desperately with the size of organization we are. And so step one was really identifying those goals and then finding out different platforms that supported those goals and figuring out which ones. And then just, we started reaching out to platforms and really just taking tours.
Awesome. And so tell us a little bit about Giveffect, how you've like started using it and both the features you like, but also I think helpful to understand like what you did as an organization to make the most out of using that more central platform.
Yeah, absolutely. So I'll be honest, from day one, when we first took the first tour of Giveffect, we knew that this was the platform for us. Giveffect was built with a lot of features that are very specific to Habitat affiliates. One being they track sweat equity hours. I was listening to the session earlier and they talked a lot about homeowners doing sweat equity, and that's a huge component to our volunteer program. And so it's already built into the system. So we really started looking at those different features, identifying what we needed and what we didn't need. The thing that we love best about Giveffect is that it's one point of truth, but it also has the capacity to take on a large amount of volunteers. As I mentioned earlier, we have on average 4,500 volunteers that come through our doors every single year. And that's literally every day of the week. We have volunteers on construction sites and restores in our offices. So we have a lot of moving pieces that we have to always be able to navigate. Giveffect lets you automate all of that. So it's also allowed us to take a position that we had and really let that position grow into something a little bit different, because we didn't need someone doing all the back-end data entry because it's all automated now. When we went to implement, we really laid out a very specific plan. And we did it in tiers. So what is step one and what are we trying to launch with step one? What is step two? We knew that we couldn't just jump in and launch the whole platform for all of our supporters. It was never going to be successful. So we took a tiered approach at implementation.
Awesome. No, I think both the planning for assessment and determining what you needed in advance and then the rollout is really powerful. What's been your biggest achievement as you've streamlined and really optimized your volunteer experience?
We are completely 100% paperless when it comes to all of our volunteers. Every single volunteer must sign up online before they come in our front door, they come to a build site, or they come to a restore. We know pretty much every volunteer that's going to come 2 weeks prior to their volunteer date. That allows us to have our construction sites or staff properly. We have the right materials they need. The work is there when they get there. The same thing goes with our restores. Projects are ready and available for them. The planning that we've been able to do because of this has been truly life-changing for our organization. In addition to that, we also can do follow-ups to really understand and evaluate our volunteer program, understand what's going well, what needs to be improved. If there's safety concerns, we can do all that very easily through a text message, through a survey, because we have everyone right in one place. So it's allowed us to really elevate our volunteer experience and focus on what needs to be improved.
Awesome. And what would be your number one piece of advice that you'd give just in general to folks that are working in volunteer programs?
Have a plan. Be able to sit down and like really identify what your goals are and make sure that whatever platform you choose meets your goals. I see all the time people reaching out to me thinking that Giveffect or another platform is right for them. But after I ask them what their goals are, they don't really know. And so make sure that you as a team and an organization have identified those goals before you take the leap in. But also after you take the leap in, make sure you have a dedicated person that can really understand the platform and lead you through the migration. It's very time consuming, but when you invest in something like this, your results, everyone will see them. We get compliments all the time about how easy it is for groups to sign up, how it's easy to, you know, they know they get a 3-day reminder, a 5-day reminder, they know where to go. Before, none of that was happening. And so now we have a very, I don't want to say plug and play, but almost plug and play volunteer program that takes all of the coordination off of our corporate groups or our individuals and lets them just really focus on their day-to-day job and then coming to volunteer with us on that specific day.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for all the insight and the tips and congratulations. And it sounds like it's probably made your work day a lot more enjoyable.
Yes.
More automated and effective. So
yeah. Really appreciate
it, Melissa.
Yeah. Thank you so much.